Okay, in this video, we are going to see how to install Flutter on Windows OS. So first of all, what you need is to download this Flutter zip file. Let me just click on it and save it. And after that, we need to download the Android Studio as well. So if you read all the steps here, you can see that all the steps are clearly mentioned, but I will do all things step by step. So first of all, we need to download it. Then we need to extract it into the C folder and source and Flutter. You can copy paste it or extract it anywhere you want, but it is recommended that you do not use the C program files folder. So as you can see, this is downloaded. Let me go to the downloads. And after that, I can see that this is here. Let me just open it in the folder. And here is our, you know, the downloaded zip file. So let me copy it or cut it and go to the C folder. And in the C folder, I can create a new folder, maybe SRC, maybe whatever you want. You can name it and go into this folder and just copy paste it. And after that, we can, you know, extract it here, extract all, and we can name it something called. Or maybe we can remove this for name and extract it here. Let's see. So it has extracted all the files into the Flutter folder, as you can see here. Okay, so what is the next step? So next step is that we need to update the path of the Flutter folder into the environment variable. So just open the environment variables option and add the Flutter bin folder. So what is the Flutter bin folder? Just go to the downloaded folder or the configured folder and just open the Flutter folder. So in the Flutter folder, you will see bin folder. Just open it, and here you can just copy the path of this folder and start or open the environment variables configuration option. So just type env here. And you need to choose the environment variables. So env, environment variables. And from here, you need to choose environment variables. Here we can see there are different options that are available. We need to choose path from here and click on edit. And here we can insert a new entry. So whatever I have copied, I have just pasted it. Just click on OK. Okay, again, and then again, okay. Now, what we have to do is that we need to verify that we have correctly copy pasted the name. So just open the command line from the Windows. Let me just open it, and here you can type Flutter Doctor. So Flutter Doctor, and let's see what it provides. So now you can see that it is giving some error, unable to find Git in your path. So we need to configure the Git as well. So let me download Git for Windows and continue completing the other steps. To download Git, you need to go to this URL. I will provide this URL in the description below and click on download 32-bit Git for Windows setup. Okay, now we can say save, and after it is downloaded, we can just go ahead and install it. So let's wait for the download. So now the Git is downloaded. Now I can click on run button, and from here all the necessary steps we have to follow to install Git. Click on next. You can go and go ahead and install it anywhere you want. So for example, C program files Git, and click on next. I think we can choose the default options and click on next. So now you can see that Git installation steps are completed, and we can just click on finish here, and let's try to run the, let's close this window for once and try to run it again. Type cmd, choose command prompt, and run again Flutter Doctor, and let's see what, you know, it shows to us. Okay, so checking Dart version. So it is downloading the Dart SDK for us for Flutter. So let's wait for this process and let's see what it asks for the next. Meanwhile, we can check out all the other steps that are required to install Flutter. Here we can see that we need to install the Android Studio as well. So just click on this URL and it will take us to the Android Studio download page where we can download the Android Studio. Just click on this button and it will download the Android Studio. It is 896 MB, so it will take a while. Just click on this checkbox and click on download and Android Studio for Windows. Okay, so on the screen you can see that the Flutter doctor has downloaded all the necessary tools. Okay, this is the version that we have right now on this machine. Secondly, we need Android toolchain developed for Android devices. So to develop Android apps using Flutter, we need to download Android Studio and all the relevant Android tools. So for example, Android SDK, Android build tools, we don't have to worry about those. Once we install the Android Studio, it automatically downloads and install all the necessary tools for us. So right now we are waiting for Android Studio to download. You can see that the download is in progress. And secondly, we need Android Studio, or we can use other, tools for developing Flutter apps. So preferably I use Visual Studio Code for developing Flutter apps, because I think it is very lightweight and also very well integrated with Flutter, but you can use Android Studio as well. In both cases, we need to install some plugins as well. So meanwhile, the Android Studio is downloading. Let me download the Visual Studio Code as well for you. Okay, to download the Visual Studio Code, it is a free software which is provided by Microsoft. You can go to this URL. I will provide this URL as well in the description below, and you can click on that to open the this page. So click on this Windows button, and from here you can start downloading the VS Code as well. Once the Visual Studio Code download is completed, we can just open it and add necessary extensions to complete this setup. Okay, now Visual Studio Code is completely installed. Let's click on Finish button and it will launch the VS Code for us. Visual Studio Code is launched as you can see on screen. Now I can go to the Extensions section. You can click on this button, Extensions. What we need right now here is Flutter, and it will show us the Flutter extension. Just click on this and click Install. This will install the necessary Flutter extension. And secondly, what we need is the Dart. I think Dart is already installed, or once we are installing the Flutter, it will also download the Dart along with it. So I think let's wait for Flutter installation, Flutter extension installation in the VS Code. And after that, we can do other steps that are required. So what Flutter extension does is that it provides all the necessary, actions and code completion for making the Flutter development easier. So it is very useful extension, I guess, in the VS Code. Without it, it will be like very difficult to manage the Flutter development. Otherwise, we will be using command line, but command line can be difficult for everyone. So VS Code extension is providing easy way to do all the necessary things. Let me just close it and let's see if our Android Studio is downloaded. Oh, by the way, Android Studio is downloaded. So let's run it and let's see how to install Android Studio on your Windows. Okay, so here is this complete setup. Let me just, see. Next, click on next. You can click on Android virtual device if you want. Yes, definitely, because we want to install the Android virtual device related setups as well. Click on next. Click on next again. Install. And it will take a while to install all the necessary files to Android Studio. And let's wait for this process. Okay, so this process is completed. Let's click on next button and let's start Android Studio if you want. Because some steps are again required to complete this process. Let's click on do not import settings and click OK. Okay, I don't want to send any analytics information to Google. And after that, it is saying Android Studio 4.2 beta is available. I can ignore this and click on next button. I can click on custom or standard. Android Studio will be installed with most common settings and options. If you want to customize it, we can choose custom and click on next button. Click on next. And if you want to choose between light theme or dark theme, you can choose here. I like the dark theme, by the way. So click on next. Here you can see, by the way, for this installation process or demo purpose, I will choose the light theme. And let's go to the next. So Android SDK platform, yes, we need that. And performance, Android emulator hypervision driver, okay, I also need that. Android virtual device, yes, I need that. And I will click on next, and after that I will click on next again. Okay, it is giving summary of all the things that will be installed or downloaded, and then our Android Studio will be ready to be used. So now it will download all the required files to configure Android environment on our device. And this process can take a while, and it all depends on your internet speed and your system configuration. So I will wait here, and let's resume the tutorial once this is completed. Okay, so now you can see that the Android Studio download setup is completed. Let's click on finish button. And after that, you can see Android Studio initial screen here. And now let's go ahead to the terminal again and close this and try to run the Flutter Doctor again. So let me restart the CMD. And from here, I can type in Flutter Doctor. So now once we run this command, we can see that now all the Android toolchain related requirements are completed, but there is one requirement that is related to Android license, not licenses not accepted. So no worries. Here the Flutter Doctor is also recommending a command that we need to run in order to accept all the licenses. So let me just copy this and paste it here, or you can manually type it and just press enter. Now right now it is asking for receive licenses that have not been accepted. I need to press Y and press enter, and again press Y and enter, and again press Y, enter, and same goes for all the licenses. We need to accept all these licenses in order to proceed further. So now all the licenses are accepted. Now let's try to run the Flutter Doctor command again to see if we are good to go. Now it is saying that Android Studio version 4.1.0 Flutter plugin not installed and Dart plugin not installed. So that's okay, because we are going to use VS Code for the development purpose. But anyway, if you want to install the Flutter plugin in the Android Studio, you can click on this button, configure, and go to the plugins. And from here you can type in Flutter and install this. You need to click on accept and then install. Once the Flutter plugin is downloaded, you need to click on the restart ID button so that you know it can pick this plugin. Let's click on restart. Now since the Flutter plugin is installed, you can see that there is a new option that is related to create a new Flutter project. We have installed all these necessary tools that are required to start with the Flutter development. So congratulations, everyone.